Okay, guys, so this is the final question. And so let's quickly get started. This is the third question on the bags and purses question. Okay, can you guys see me? Okay, I hope you guys can see me. And I've increased the size of the, okay. So let's quickly get started. So basically this one says that there's a company that makes bags and purses, and the main aspect of this question was to determine the cost driver that should be used for the allocation of the cost. Okay. So if you read this thing, it says that each design is made in small batches. Each spring, the company comes out with a new design for the backpack and purses. The company uses these designs for a year and then moves to a new trend. The bags are made from the same fabrication equipment that is expected to operate at capacity. The equipment must be switched over to a new design and set up to prepare for the new production of the new batch. When completed, each batch of product is immediately transported to the wholesaler, and transportation cost varies with the number of consignments. Okay. Now they have given you the direct material and direct labor for purses, and then direct material for backpacks and direct labor for backpacks. Okay. These are the first two things that are given to you. So directly you can copy these things. Okay. So this is how I'll just delete these. So these are the direct material and direct labor. This will be constant for even for ABC or traditional. In this case, they have not asked for the traditional, but so direct labor, this is a total given. Okay, so total purses is this amount. And, this is a purses. So purses is this amount. And the labor for purses is this amount. Backpack is equal to this amount, and labor for bags is this amount. Okay, so why I have split it in per unit and total is because the question says that budgeted cost, total cost, and per unit cost for each product line. So that's why I have shifted it per unit and total. Okay, now my direct labor and direct, this is done. All I can do is just divide this by the number of bags. So over here I have backpacks 6175, and if I do Control D, it will just use the same formula. Wait, I didn't fix it. So F4, yeah, done. Now coming here, it will be this one divided by 3075 and this one divided by 3075 again. So this is the total direct material cost and direct labor cost. This is done. This is the simplest part. Now comes the indirect cost that were given, and you needed to determine the cost drivers which were being used. So here, if you read the question properly, setup, it says that every time there's a new batch, setup has to prepare for the new batch. So every time there's a new batch, you need to incur setup cost. Okay, so that's why setup has been taken on this part. Transportation is again based on the number of consignment, and over here it says that every time it says that once it was produced, this when completed, each batch is transported to the wholesaler. So every batch is transported as a consignment, so that's why it's also on the basis of number of batches. Design is given over here that So design is easy. Design will be on the basis of the number of designs, and plant utilization, plant utilities and admin, this is based on the number of hours. Okay. So these are my cost drivers given, and I've determined this one. So good presentation would be to like write down the cost drivers in this tabular format. So it's easier for whoever is evaluating to understand the cost driver that you've taken. Batches, designs, and hours of production. Okay, total units, it's already given over here. So batches is equal to this one. This is also this one. Designs is 4 and hours of production is 4 to this one. Okay, now cost driver rate is very easy. It's this one divided by number of units down. So this is my cost driver rate for each of these costs. Now what, it's very simple. I know the number of bags. So cost driver, I'll calculate the total cost and then divide it by the number of units and I'll get the thing. Okay. So setup, for setup, I know the rate is this 320 multiplied by, where is my setup cost? So setup is number of batches. So number of batches is 120. Okay. And again, this one is 320 multiplied by number of batches is 80. Because shipping is the where was I? Sorry, 365 multiplied by again, it's the number of batches. So I'll come over here, multiply this again, 365 multiplied by number of batches. Done. So one thing you can do to confirm whether you're doing it correctly or not, just add these two and you'll see 64,000. And you know, your setup is 64,000. And this one again, you add 73,000. If this is matching, that means that your allocation is correct. Design, again, design is 42, this one into 2 and equal to this one into 2. Plant admin 52 multiplied by hours of production. And again, equal to 52 multiplied by hours production. Okay, so my total cost has been calculated. I need to just calculate my per unit cost. So this is again, this divided by, I'll just type it so that it's easy, number of bags. So 6175. Yes. Now, if I drag this down, it will automatically calculate. And this is divided by 3075. Got it. So that gives me the total per unit cost. And so I'll just use. Okay. So this is how I would present the entire question if this question came. And I hope you guys got the presentation part. Some people have calculated this like number of setups, number of setup cost, number of setups. So I think this is a much cleaner presentation and would take a lot less time. So I think if you present it in this way, it's much better. Okay. So this is the total per unit cost and total cost. Okay. So if you have any questions regarding this question as well, you can comment it down below, or you can reach out to me and I'll help you out with this. Okay. So best of luck for the CM exam. I think some other people are making videos for activity, for the budgetary thing. And what was the other thing? Budget and decision-making. So I think other people are making videos for those and they'll be uploaded soon. Okay. So best of luck for tomorrow's paper.